Spring is in the air, and it is a beautiful day to do some spring homemaking. I shared a sunrise and a sunset in another vlog, and today's just was breathtaking. I love waking up when the sun is rising and just seeing God's handiwork and all of that beauty. But I'm starting off my day with getting my diffuser going with a beautiful scent and getting my coffee and my heavy cream and just getting the day rolling. It is a day of a little bit of cleaning. I like to do my weekly cleaning of the bedrooms on this particular day. So I already dusted and now it's time to get my floors cleaned. If you haven't heard, I live in a 950 square foot home and so we have two bedrooms. So cleaning the bedrooms is not too big of a feat, but today I am doing a little bit more deep cleaning as after I'm done with my bedroom, my husband and my bedroom, and our little boys, baby boys' bedroom, then I'll move to our girls'. Also, if you missed my shared closet makeover, check that out in the description box below. It was a pretty simple mini DIY, just adding some wallpaper and decluttering and organizing. Making even those hidden spaces beautiful is important. But moving over to my daughter's room, and my floor cleaner is my same spray that I use for lots of different things. It's water, vinegar, and lemon essential oil. So it's okay for the baby to be on the floor because it's all natural. So every once in a while, we need to take care of our kids' rooms, right? Do some deep cleaning. I am getting under my oldest daughter's bed because I'm sure there's some hidden treasures underneath and some dust bunnies that have gone a little wild under there. So finding some fun things, some play phone. You'll see I find a Christmas ornament. So obviously I haven't done this since then, at least. Some other little toys and wiping the walls down because I was kind of shocked at how dusty walls get behind beds and behind furniture that's against the wall. So definitely don't forget to wipe your baseboards and your walls because the dust buildup goes on that just as much as it does on the floor. So after that was done, pushing it back and just getting it reset, I usually let her make the bed, so I didn't really adjust it too much because it's her job to make her bed in the morning, and so just leaving that. And then I am putting their stuffed animals back, and I'll be moving on over to my toddler's toddler bed. Did the similar routine with this bed, wipe on the walls, wipe under the bed, and just get it a lot more fresher and clean. I do try to keep the toy amount in their room pretty minimal. There's some in the closet, but not a whole lot, and books in that box there. But if you did miss back in August, so several months ago, I shared my whole home tour organized for you. And just how our house is laid out. So check that out if you want to see how our house is done up to live in as a family of five. So finishing up making some more cleaning spray because when you use it for everything, it goes pretty fast. So I like to wash all my rags together at one time during the week, so just threw that in before we headed out for a little stroll. My little side garden beside our cement area has some green coming up and it just brings life back to the space. Alright, so now I'm going to do a little bit more spring decorating. in my living area. I did do a spring decorating video not too long ago, but did not change the pillow covers. So I was thinking of keeping them neutral, but I did add a little bit more pops of color with this floral pillow. I got it from Walmart last year and it had tassels on it. Tassels with little kids are not the safest thing. So one got ripped off and then one of you suggested cut the other ones off. So I did, and now it's just cute as can be. Perfect for this little side chair next to our big window and add some color. And then my other pillows are literally thrifted, whether they're covers or pillows. So threw some pink in there. I have these other blue ones that you see on that love seat by the built-ins. Not sure exactly if I'll keep those or not, but you know, just adding a little bit more color because spring is about life and color and new growth. Then it's time to do some kitchen cleaning and spring decorating. So I keep my counter super minimal. I want a space to be able to work at the end that you can't really see. I do sometimes get like papers and some like homeschool stuff on there, but right now it's got to be cleared off because I need to oil butcher block countertop and wipe down the subway tile. So our butcher block countertop has done us well for 6 years, I want to say. We DIY'd our kitchen after we bought the place, and it's holding up pretty well. It is a little more rough in some spots because it does not have a seal on it, and I do not cut on it. But it is a piece that I think just adds character to the home. Gives a little more farmhouse, cottage feel, and so I kind of like that anyways. So I'm just oiling it with this Bob's oil, I guess. I think I have it in my Amazon store if you're interested. I even use it on my wood cutting boards, so it works for that as well. And it's food safe, food grade safe. So while that dries, I am going to redecorate my accordion rack by our espresso machine. The one staple that stays the same on this rack is my apron. So I really like this crossbody apron. And then I'm gonna add some florals, faux florals, of course. So most of these are thrifted, or the tulips are one of my favorites from Amazon. And I did it very simply last year. You can check over on my blog for some spring decorating inspiration if you want to find that there. And this is what I've decided on for now. I'm sure it'll change probably by the time spring comes around. And I don't know if I'm gonna do a full spring tour or not. I just might share little snippets here and there in some of my other videos. But then I just like to use more flowers all throughout my kitchen as well, in my vintage pictures, and just make it more lively. Okay, so this picture that I have of this chair and pot of flowers is adorable, but I actually ended up moving it from there. I'm not sure I'm a huge fan of it leaning against my counters like that, so it did not stay after I put it there. And then this little plate, they're like a set of four seasonal plates I have that I change out in my kitchen for every season. I think they're from Courier and Ives, I wanna say, but of course another thrifted find. Then I'm just putting everything else back on my counter since the oil has dried. Of course, I need to get my latte fix in that I made myself. And I am still working on that latte art a little bit. And you'll see, I kind of made a leaf of some sort. So anyways, after that and after nap time, I am digging up some of my grasses. It's too early to clean the garden because we still have frost. We still have freezing temperatures at night. But I'm just digging some of the decorative ornamental grasses up because they have taken over, and it is time for me to rearrange my cottage style garden. And that's the beauty of a cottage style garden. You can do that. You can take things out, you can transplant, you can move it around. And I have these little stepping stones that my girls love walking on that I just wanted to have space for. So I am taking that out and just making it hopefully a new creation of a cottage garden. Tonight's supper is sourdough, pizza, but it is just pizza. And this pizza crust is one I go to if I don't use my sourdough starter. So it's just a fun little change to have. And husband's home from work and just getting the meal prepped and started and enjoying the conversation. My husband likes to help in the kitchen, but he also likes to snitch some of the food as I put it together. But who doesn't, right? So after it was baked, we enjoy a beautiful supper of just some pizza, and I was out of lettuce, so we just had some cooked vegetables from the freezer. They're always a staple in my house as well. But I had to make sure to plate it up and show you. It's just, the kids really love this pizza, so... Anyways, had to light the candles for our meal as well and enjoy the sunset as it streams in through the kitchen window, share some zevias with my husband and my kids, and just enjoy sitting down at a meal together.